Welcome to this OpenShot Video Editor complete tutorial for beginners, where in only a few minutes you will learn everything you need to start editing videos easily. I'm Edward Stinga from videoplasty.com, the only platform online where you can get amazing stock animation or animated GIF images for commercial purposes. Let's get started. OpenShot Video Editor is a free open source video editing software that you can easily download from their website, link in the description. It's available for all major platforms such as Windows, Mac, and Linux. What I like about OpenShot Video Editor is that it's very user-friendly and easy to get started with, but also packs a lot of power features under the hood for advanced users. The interface is split into a few separate panels. On the top left, we have the project panel where we can import and browse our project files, but can also find transitions and effects. On the top right, we have the preview panel where we can see our edited video. And on the bottom, we have the timeline, which is the heart of all non-linear editors where all the video editing magic happens. Now, let's import some media files into our project. To import files, you can right-click on the Project Files panel and select Import Files. Another option that most people actually use is to have your files in a folder on your computer, select them, and just drag and drop them inside the Project Files panel. You will be able to see a thumbnail preview of your files to easily pick the one you want. You can also use a filter to easily find files based on their type, such as video, audio, or images. If you have a lot of files, you can also use the search functionality to easily find the one that you're looking for. You can change the settings of your project by clicking the red film strip to change the profile using the drop-down menu. I suggest you stick with HD profiles or 4K profiles, depending on your desired frame rate and resolution. Now, let's add some items onto the timeline and do some basic editing. To do that, all you have to do is drag and drop a media file at the right time on the timeline. The red line here is called a playhead. If you grab it at the top, you can move it around the timeline at various points in time. If you hit the play button on the preview window or the space bar, it will start playing the timeline from where the playhead is positioned. An important tool on the timeline is the timeline scale. You can use the plus button to zoom in on your timeline and go more granular on your edit, down to the second. Or you can use the minus button to zoom out and get a high-level overview of your edit. The timeline is organized in different tracks, and OpenShot Video Editor starts with 5 tracks by default. For easy editing, it's recommended you keep audio and video on separate tracks. You can right-click on the track to add a new track, rename it, or remove the track. The track order is also important to keep in mind for video files. The video or image that is on the track above will always show first. If it doesn't fill up the entire screen, it will reveal what's on the track underneath it, and so on. For audio tracks, the order doesn't matter, as the audio will just get mixed together, so you will hear both tracks. You can also view the audio waveform of your video or music by right-clicking on the file, Display, Show Waveform. This shows the audio volume through time. To trim a clip, all you have to do is grab it at the end and move your mouse, then release. Keep in mind, this will remove that part of the media file from your timeline edit. To split a video or audio in two, you can use the razor tool and click anywhere on a clip. Now you can move the pieces around as you want. Or you can select one of the resulting clips and click backspace to remove it. If a video has both video and audio content, you can separate them into two separate tracks by right-clicking on it, separate audio, and single clip. to make some more advanced edits, you can right-click on a clip and select Properties. This allows you to change the alpha or transparency, crop the video, adjust the positioning in the frame, change the scale, or adjust the volume of the audio. You can edit the values of those properties by holding the left click and moving it left and right, or by double clicking on the value and entering a number manually. It's always useful to add transitions to make the switch from one clip to another more pleasing. There are a few ways you can do that. To add a simple fade, you can right-click on the video on the timeline, go to Fade, then add a fade at the start of the clip, at the end of the clip, or if you select the entire clip, it will add a fade both at the start and end of it. To add a fade to the audio, you can right-click on the audio file on your timeline, go to Volume, Start of Clip, Fade In. You can of course also add the fade to the end of the clip or to both at the same time. For more transitions, you need to navigate to the Transitions panel where you will find a lot of transition presets that you can use. To add a transition to a clip, find the one that you want to use and drag and drop it on the timeline. It will be a little long, so first you have to make it shorter by trimming it. This will create a start transition. You can do the exact same thing for the end, but this time you will have to right-click on the transition and select Reverse Transition. To do a nice transition from one clip to another without fade to black, add the next clip right under the previous one. Moving on to some more advanced features, you can also add some visual effects to your video editing by going to the Effects panel here. Like before, you will have to drag and drop an effect directly on your desired video clip. You will notice they appear as small icons on top of the clip. Click on the icon to open up the Properties panel for that effect, where you can control settings specific to each effect. To add text or titles in OpenShot, you need to go to the top bar and select Title, then Title again. This is where you can choose from a few different presets available. Each preset can be customized on the right side. You can enter the file name, which is how you will find the clip in the project files. You can then change every piece of text inside it. Then you can change the font, the text color, or the background color. When done, click Save. Your title will be added as a clip in the project files. Then you can add to timeline and use it like you would any other clip. For example, you might want to add a transition, such as a simple fade. When you've finished editing your video and are ready to share it with the world, it's time to export your project. To do that, click the red circle button on the top navigation menu that looks like a record button. In this panel, you can give your project a file name. Select where you want it to be saved on your computer, and select some more advanced settings when it comes to your video compression. These are all fairly advanced, so I suggest you stick with the default settings to export as MP4 on the highest quality preset, as this is one of the most popular video formats in the world. Then click Export. Depending on the complexity of your project, duration, and the computer you're on, this can take a while to fully process everything and export your project as a video file.
Alright, that was my OpenShot Video Editor complete tutorial for beginners. I hope you liked it, and I hope now you will go and make your own amazing videos and share them with the world. For more incredibly helpful video assets such as stock animation that will help you produce professionally looking animated videos directly in OpenShot Video Editor with drag and drop simplicity, make sure to visit videoplasty.com. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. I really appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video, it would be great if you could gently tap the like button and leave a comment. It really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And for more useful content in the world of video editing, video animation, and starting and growing a YouTube channel, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out. I'm Edward Stenga from videoplasty.com. Follow me on Instagram as well at Edward Stenga to keep up with what I'm doing and say hi. I hope you enjoyed this video, and until next time, stay creative.